In this video, you will learn two ways of finding what devices are connected to your local network and Linux. Stay tuned. So I'll be using two tools here. One command line, which is very popular, nmap. And there's also a GUI tool called Angry IP Scanner, which is quite easy to use for the beginners and advanced users alike. So let's start with the popular command line tool nmap first, and then later on we will see the Angry IP Scanner GUI tool. To use nmap, you have to install it first. In my case, it is already installed. And then you should know your IP address. So here, my IP address is 192.168.1.63, and then 24 is the subnet mask. So I'll be using this information with nmap, -sn, and then instead of using the 63 in the IP address, I'll go with the starting point of the scan, which is 0 or 1, and then /24 is the subnet mask. So it will be searching for 192.168.1.0 till 1.255. So just press enter and wait for the scan to complete. It might take a few seconds. And then as you can see, it has scanned 4 hosts, but I don't trust nmap as much. So I keep it running a couple of times. As you can see, immediately it shows 5 hosts up now. It is not easy to remember the nmap options. So you can go to the man page of nmap and try to find the information. Alternatively, if you're using a terminal like warp with built-in AI, you can just ask it for example on using nmap. Not a very good question, so I'll rephrase it to nmap. Check for local devices, and then I can see that it has suggested something, even the command. So I run it from the same interface, and it shows the result, and it also tries to explain the output, providing some context to it. So if AI is your thing, you can use warp. Another way to scan IP addresses on Linux system is by using this GUI tool called Angry IP Scanner. You have to provide the IP address range you want to scan and just hit the start button. And you will see it starts scanning all the IP addresses, starts pinging them, and waits for the reply. So it has scanned 254 ports, and out of that, 10 hosts are alive and 5 of them have open ports. This is the summary of the scan. So let's go into the details. This is the gateway 1.1, and then you see a whole bunch of red IP addresses. These are actually the inactive IP addresses with no devices on them. And then you see some blue dots, which means there probably is a device, but it is not replying to the ping. It is probably a smartphone. So that's okay. What is interesting is the green ones. These are the real desktop operating system, like a computer, a proper computer that replies to your ping, and you can probably ping them, or if they have SSH enabled, you can also connect to them via SSH, the actual devices which you would want to connect to. And you can see that they also show the port number. If they have a port open, there's a port number displayed. So this is one way of doing things. You could actually configure the scan to have more information or even less information. For example, you can display the MAC addresses when you scan, or similarly, you can remove things and have less information. It is really up to you what you want to see in the result. What I really like to do is to change the display settings and only show the alive ports, you know, or only the active ones with open ports, you know, the green ones or green and blue ones. This way you won't see all those dead IP addresses with red dots and only see what actually matters. And what matters is the active host on your subnetwork. You will also notice that some of the devices tell their host names, while some do not. It is really up to the devices if they want to share their host name or not. The terminal one or the GUI here. I will let you share which one you prefer, nmap or angry IP scanner, in the comment section.